So I've got a little bit of a confession to make. In all of the years that I've been cooking, I've very, very rarely made any Indian food. And the reason is because I've always been a little bit too intimidated by it. There's a lot of spices going on. I didn't know if I was doing it correctly, and I was kind of scared to mess it up. That is until I finally made an Indian dish, at least what I call an Indian dish. And so what I'm sharing with you today is my take on a paleo vegan cauliflower curry with coconut milk. It is so friggin' delicious. You're gonna love it. So stick around, I'm gonna show you how to make this bad boy. So I'm just gonna chop up some onion first. And it's funny because I took quite a bit of grief in my shakshuka video for not having any knife skills. And I appreciate all of your concern and your comments, but I assure you, my knife skills are just fine. I don't know. I mean, maybe you think I don't have great knife skills. Let me know in the comments. Comment below, let me know. My eyes are watering again. Oh. I'm crying. If you've got a tip for how to chop onions without your eyes watering like this, please let me know in the comments. I need an answer, I need a solution. Next, we want a couple cloves of garlic. And for this, I like a lot of garlic. This is a very intensely flavored dish, so I go for about 4 or 5 cloves of garlic. With your palm of your hand, crush them. Just like that. I mean, easiest way. You get your frustrations out too. You had a rough day at the office, smash some garlic. I'm gonna give it just a rough chop. If this is to your liking, go ahead. If you want to make it a little bit finer, you can always do a cross chop over top, just like that. But personally, I don't fuss around with this too much. This goes straight into the bowl along with the onions. We're going to cook this all together. The next thing we need here is some ginger, fresh ginger root. And this is what it looks like. If you've never cooked with it, it is fantastic. Not only is it delicious, it is super healthy, anti-inflammatory, great for digestion, great for your blood. Eat this in everything. I put this in my smoothie every single morning. And I like it. Just need about 2 or 3 tablespoons of this. You could absolutely peel this with a knife, like so. But you might end up taking a lot of the actual ginger off. So the easiest way to do this is with a spoon. And it's much safer. I mean, you can get your kids involved in the kitchen. You don't want them handling a knife? By all means, give them a spoon and a piece of ginger and let them go to work. What I do with the ginger actually is I don't chop it. I want to grate it. It's much easier. You'll see all of this juice that's going to get released from the ginger. So this is all that juice I was talking about. And you just don't get that if you chop it by hand. So that goes all in there along with the onions and the garlic. That's about all we need prep for now. Let's just bring this bad boy over here. We're going to turn this on to about a medium heat. And the first thing I wanna do is toast some spices. This is a really crucial step, I find. In any kind of South Asian or Southeast Asian cooking, it's really important to toast the spices first. It makes them super aromatic, it draws out a lot of the essential oils, and it'll increase the flavor of the dish significantly. So I've got some coriander seed here, and I'm gonna go with about a teaspoon of coriander seed. I've got some fennel seed. And then I've got some cumin seed. So a teaspoon of each. I want to heat them up in a dry pan until they become aromatic and release some of their essential oils. And I can already start to smell all of these flavors coming out of the spices. And this has been only about 45 seconds. All right, so these have been toasting now for about 2 minutes. And I'm just going to transfer them to a mortar and pestle here. Really just want to start to bash these. And we're going to grind them up by hand. And it's a little bit more time consuming, but I feel as though it's much more rewarding. I don't know. Call me old fashioned. You could absolutely put this in a food processor, but this is just fun. Beautiful powder from those spices that we've toasted. And oh my God, the smell is out of this world. We're gonna go onto a medium-high heat here. I think Indian food has a really bad rap. It's always labeled as something that you feel really heavy after, really tired, lethargic. But Indian food can be made extremely, extremely healthy. And in fact, it is really healthy. It's just about the ingredients you use to make the dish. Turmeric, ginger, all these things are fantastic. Garlic, great health benefits. And we're gonna keep it really healthy. We're gonna use coconut oil. It's great for high heat cooking, and it's got a number of nutritional benefits. We're gonna toast some mustard seed. You'll see the mustard seed is gonna start to sizzle a little bit. And then once that starts to happen, we're gonna go in with our onions, and our garlic, and our ginger, right in. We're gonna drop the heat to a medium-low. I'm gonna cook these down for about 8 to 10 minutes to soften them. But look, if they get a little bit of color on them, it's perfectly fine. They're not burnt. They'll be a little bit caramelized. And I think people have a really hard time with putting color on their veggies. While my onions and garlic and ginger and mustard seeds are sauteing, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get to work on my tomatoes. I just make a little incision at the top, and I box grate them. And then what happens is all of the tomato juice goes down into the plate, but the skin gets left completely intact. This is a trick a friend of mine taught me, which is brilliant. So I'm gonna do the exact same thing on tomato number two. I'm just gonna make a little incision here, and I'm just gonna grate this bad boy up. Perfect. Once our onions get to this point, really soft, you've got a little bit of color on them, again, it's perfectly fine. We're gonna go in with some spices. Yes, this dish requires a lot of spices. But you know what? I encourage you to make it. Live a little, have some fun in the kitchen. First thing we're gonna use is garam masala. This is a blend of spices. I think it varies depending on the household. I mean, different household will make it a different way. So I've just got a store-bought garam masala. You can make this on your own, but I'm just gonna go in with about half a teaspoon. Next, I want some turmeric powder. Very healthy. Color, first of all, is just beautiful. I mean, it's this golden hue, which is just absolutely fantastic. We're gonna hit it with a bit of cayenne pepper. So I'm going in with about 3/4 of a teaspoon. That's not spicy for a lot of Indian people I know, but we're gonna make a mild version. If you like it spicier, add more. Next, we want ground cardamom, just because I really like this flavor. This goes a long way, so just use a little bit. I use about 1/4 of a teaspoon. Next, we want some cumin. I have a little bit of cumin in the garam masala already, so I want about 1/2 teaspoon in this. We want to hit it with a nice pinch of salt, and that's going to just help to bring out all of the other flavors. So give that a stir, and we want to toast these spices. Oh, and I almost forgot. We've got all of those beautiful spices that we ground earlier. Now we just want to toast these guys up for about 45 seconds, just to release a little bit more of those flavors. We're gonna go in with coconut milk. Oh, and look at the color. Already the color is becoming this really beautiful golden hue. Stir this around carefully. We wanna go in with our tomatoes. What we wanna do is we just wanna drain it. And the way I do it is just through a sieve. Just like that. If a little bit of the juice goes in there, it's not a big deal. But we don't want a super watery curry. Now we're gonna give this a stir. Oh man, the color is just phenomenal. So it's at this point that we actually want to get the cauliflower in. Just start to peel away all of these little stems, which we don't want. Once you get that main stem off, everything else can just peel apart. They're quite big chunks, so we just want to chop these down into little manageable guys. So in we go with our cauliflower. And see how much we can fit in there. Almost the entire cauliflower will fit in here. So now, just to help it cook down, we're gonna hit it with a lid. And whatever's left over, you just heat. And don't forget to feed your camera person. Cleanup time. While this is bubbling away, I actually want to get to work on a little bit of a sauce I'm going to put over top of the curry. I'm going to use the coconut milk that we had earlier. Still got a bunch left over. I'm just going to pour it into a little bit of a bowl. I'm going to hit it with some lime juice. And the lime juice is gonna make it nice and acidic and kind of make it into a kind of coconut yogurt. Go in with some cucumber. I wanna remove the seeds. I'm just gonna run the spoon down the middle of the cucumber. I want the cucumber to almost be like ribbons. This goes into our coconut milk. I just wanna check on our curry here. Oh, it's beautifully bubbling away. And I can just tell by touching it, the cauliflower is really, really nice and soft. It's almost there. I think it'll be really, really nice with a little bit of fresh cilantro. I'm just gonna give this a bit of a fine chop. All of this right in. So I do wanna give this one last taste. Oh, it's really nice. That cilantro has really added a lot of flavor, a lot of texture, and it's thickened up the sauce. I'm gonna set that aside. At this point, it's pretty much ready. I do wanna taste it for seasoning, just to make sure I don't need any more salt. Go in with a spoon here. And it's really hot, so I'm gonna try not to burn my mouth. It always happens that I burn my mouth. Oh. That is really good. It's so flavorful. Spicy, as in it has a lot of spices, but it's not super hot to the point where, you know, I can't breathe and I start sweating or anything like that. But it's definitely got a lot of kick in there. That's ready. Look how beautiful this is. The way I finish this now is I take some of this dressing we made and I'm just gonna spoon it right over top. Like that. I do wanna hit it with a little bit of fresh chili. Let them fall where they may. So this just goes right in to a little bowl. A little dressing over top. Do want to put a little bit of fresh lime juice over top as well, just for a little bit of extra acidity. Oh, smells so good. Mmm. Wow. Cauliflower is so tender. There's so much happening in my mouth right now. It's an explosion of flavor. Spices. I don't even know what's happening. I couldn't tell you. Try this. Make this for your friends. Make it for your family and unleash your primal gourmet. Mm. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you loved it, hit the subscribe button right here. I'll put it right on my face. Just subscribe to my face. Oh, it's a big chunk. Mmm.